Good evening, and it certainly is, finally. I ask all guests and graduates to please rise and remain standing as the senior members of the choir take their places for the singing of the national anthem. Will the members of the New Fairfield High School Civil Air Patrol please post the colors? You may be seated. Dr. Craw, Mr. Cipollone, Board of Education members, Selectman Hall, parents, guardians, grandparents, faculty and staff, and most importantly, students, welcome to the 48th commencement exercises for New Fairfield High School. I want to begin tonight by acknowledging the faculty and staff who are assembled here today. They represent all of the teachers, paraprofessionals, and staff who have worked with our students from the time they entered kindergarten and dedicated themselves to helping these young people grow into the productive citizens we will send out into the world today. Please join me in thanking these wonderful professionals. I usually save this part for the end, but I also want to thank all of our custodians and facility staff who really made tonight come together. After that rainstorm, they were waiting like a small army with leaf blowers and towels, making sure that we could all enjoy this evening with the class of 2023. Let's hear it for our custodial and facilities staff. This is my 7th graduation as a high school principal, the 4th in New Fairfield. Every graduation is a special occasion. Obviously my own, which we had to have in that gym up there, on a rainy day in 1994. 2017 sticks out because it was my first as a principal, and 2019 because it capped 18 years in the same school district. 2020 was by far the most interesting, with drive-up diplomas and a drive-in ceremony at Squans Pond. But 2023, weather aside, is already at the top of my list because for the first time, I'm experiencing it as a principal and earlier this week as a dad. 4 years ago, I was a freshman again alongside all of you at New Fairfield High School. At the same time, my oldest son, Ben, was in his freshman year at high school. And, you know, after doing something for almost 20 years, you can start to feel expert at it. I felt totally confident, calm, and collected, giving sage advice to the parents of my students, you know, calling on 2 decades of experience. As the father of a high school student, well, that confidence was shattered. As a principal, I was living my best life, if not on Insta or TikTok, then at least on open house night. In school, kids' mistakes were natural, not to be obsessed over, and part of the learning process. At home, my own kids' mistakes felt like daggers, personal failures. In school, kids might get in fights, say cruel things, be disrespectful and worse, but I could hold to my belief that all young people can learn, be sensitive to the fact that unseen traumas can impact kids in unpredictable ways, and that almost all damage to relationships can be restored. At home, I could feel like the anger emotion from inside out and start World War III over a missed homework assignment or dirty socks piling up. So, to the class of 2023, I owe all of you a debt of gratitude. You showed my dad brain, which could be overly protective and critical, that high schoolers, including my own, are far more resilient and resourceful than sometimes the adults give them credit for. And that at home, I could lean into the principal brain that has a belief in your power to adapt, to improve, and to thrive. Among you are obviously commended scholars, award-winning artists, and championship athletes. More importantly to me, however, among you are also incredible humans who have experienced tragic personal loss, physical, emotional, and medical difficulties, and other obstacles which have challenged your own or others' expectations for you. And in the face of all of that, yours is a class of students who challenge and exceed what is expected, who can express and have differences with one another, but come together when it counts, even when it rains on your parade and your prom, and your other prom, and your graduation. This class might be wise to avoid planning any outdoor weddings in the future, just saying. Well, a little rain earlier tonight is not going to hold us back from celebrating the class of 2023. It's now my pleasure to introduce the assistant principal for the class, Mr. Mike Chaplot, New Fairfield High School class of 1990.
Good evening, everyone, especially the class of 2023. It is my honor to introduce one of the co-valedictorians for this year's 2023 graduating class, Kelly Carroll. Voted most likely to succeed by her peers and highly respected by her teachers, Kelly Carroll is an extraordinary student who has a work ethic, strong work ethic, an ambitious nature, a desire to learn, and a compassion for social justice. Kelly has always challenged herself in her academics, amply demonstrated by the nature and level of classes she has pursued during her time at New Fairfield High School. While Kelly has always displayed all the gifts of a very excellent student, she also embodies the attributes of great character, humanity, leadership, and citizenship. Her teachers unanimously concur that she is a pleasure to teach, and she never deviates from her fidelity to her work. She is a model citizen and a student who is extremely well organized and always prepared. Kelly is a young woman who has continuously demonstrated compassion toward issues in her immediate community and the greater world in which she lives. She is a mature young woman who strives to lead by example. Kelly is kind, responsible, an optimistic individual whose dedication and character also make her a naturally authentic and powerful leader to whom others naturally gravitate to both for her company and for her guidance. Her role as member and vice president of the Peace Project Club, her long-term involvement in Girl Scouts, and her membership in the Mental Health Awareness Club are all a testament to her commitment to not only New Fairfield High School, but also to the community at large. Kelly's academic accolades include, but are not limited to, induction into the National Honor Society, the Spanish Honor Society, and the Chinese Honor Society. Kelly has been awarded the Rensselaer Medal, the Cornell Book Award, the Girl Scout Silver Award, the Outstanding Mathematics Award, incredible, the Outstanding Science Student Award, and the Francine Cunningham Math Award. Not only is Kelly an extremely strong student and valued activist, she is able to balance academics with a part-time job, working with young children, along with participation in the Spanish club, the New Fairfield soccer team, and the track and field teams during her high school tenure. This young woman has made her mark here at New Fairfield High School, and she will undoubtedly continue to amaze those around her. Kelly's off to Lehigh University in the fall, where she will be studying engineering. Everybody, Kelly Carroll.
Hello, everyone. Congratulations, class of 2023. So I used to think valedictorians were these cool, awe-inspiring people, and that the good grades they got in school unlocked a new level of wisdom only certain few can get. But speaking to you now, I can tell you that's not true. There's no secret underground lair or magic initiation. And I think it's a little strange now to be giving you all a speech, because I'm in the same boat as you all. We're all entering a new world full of new and unexpected adventures. I'm not sure where I'm going or where life will take me, but I like to think that's a reminder that wherever you are in life and wherever you're going, it's going to be okay. College, a career, or trade, wherever you're going, I believe you guys can do great things. Now, as a class of 2023, we might not get a brand new school or a High School Musical-esque cafeteria, but we get to say we were the last class of New Fairfield High School as we know it now, asbestos and all. Even though our school is being destroyed in just a few months or weeks, there may not be a physical record that we existed at New Fairfield High School, aside from our yearbooks, but we'll keep our memories and the effects of our actions and relationships. So I ask you to be kind, cherish your friends and those who you genuinely care about, and choose to be who you want to be, and to give others around you a bit more happiness and hope, because that's what we'll leave behind. I hope to see some of you guys in the news one day and brag about going to the same school as you. But your success depends on who defines it, whether it's money and fame, a loving family, a white picket fence, or six cats. Good luck and goodbye for now. I wish you all the absolute best and an amazing future, because I know you can do it. Happy graduation.
It is now my pleasure to introduce the chair of the New Fairfield Board of Education, Mr. Dominic Cipollone.
Good afternoon, everyone. You know, it's a very special day, and I promise to keep my words to 20 minutes because of the rain. So, you're a very special group of young people for many reasons. But the first one that comes to mind is the fact that you entered high school while the world entered a pandemic. I share this with you not because of the pandemic, but because I want to remind you all of the potential to overcome obstacles that lives inside each one of you. Thank you and welcome everyone to the commencement of the 2023 New Fairfield High School graduation. I'd like to share a few thoughts as you're about to enter this next exciting chapter of your young lives. Three words come to mind. They're easy to remember. Just think ABC. Attitude, boldness, and courage. Let me explain why I think these three words are words to live by. First, attitude. Your attitude will be one of the key drivers of your success in life. It's how you look at things. You know, you could wake up one morning, drive your car, and get a flat tire and let it ruin your whole day. Or you could take care of the flat tire, fix it, be on your way, and not think twice about it. You know, how you look at things will determine how you face obstacles in your life. And having a positive attitude is a key driver to your success. So keep that in mind, please. Don't let a bad event ruin your whole day. It's the choice you have. Don't sweat the small stuff. Find something every day to laugh about because life is really funny. Second word, boldness. Being bold is about being true to yourself and your values. Your parents have worked for the past 18 years to provide you with everything that got you here today. They provided you with all the tools and resources to achieve and succeed. Don't be shy about who you are and how important to this world you are. Be bold and you will achieve goals you didn't think were possible and overcome obstacles you never thought you could. Fear is your enemy. Third word is courage. It comes from the Latin word cor, which means heart. Courage is not about doing some dumb dare that you get pressured into doing. No. Courage comes from your heart and being able to do what your heart tells you is right. When you are at an impasse in life and are unsure or scared, quiet yourself and listen to your heart. It's usually right. Finally, go out there and live a life that is filled with happiness, gratitude, and commitment. Never lose sight of what is really important. Define your own greatness and live your best life. May God bless and protect each and every one of you today and all the days of your lives. Thank you. More importantly now, it's my privilege to introduce the new Fairfield High School class of 2023 co-valedictorian. This year's co-valedictorian, pardon me, is Claire Anderson. Claire is an outstanding young woman who has most certainly distinguished herself academically during the course of her tenure here at New Fairfield High School. As you would imagine, Claire has challenged herself by taking on an academic workload worthy of most ardent of students. Not only did she take over 8 AP level courses and 8 honors level courses, but she earned nearly perfect scores across the board in all. Very impressive. Even more impressive than her academic successes were the social justice work that Claire did throughout her time at New Fairfield. There have been many people who, upon meeting Claire and getting to know her, have remarked, "That girl is going to change the world." Hardworking and talented, with a never-ending drive, would just be the start of trying to describe this incredible young woman. But to get a greater picture of what an inspiring young person Claire truly is, let me defer to those who know her best as both a scholar and person. I'll read you some quotes from some of her teachers. Claire is constantly seeking out new information and learning, always looking to dig deeper into the meaning of things and to understand how things are connected. She is also a caring individual dedicated to the causes of equity and access for everyone. That's from Mr. Garcia. Next quote. Claire was an exemplary student and citizen every day at APUS, or APUSH, as it's known. She combines extremely gifted analytical and compositional writing skills, be nice if I could say it, with superlative advocacy skills and all the elements of great character. Her passion for social justice drives her to activism to build a better community and world. She will continue to make a great and positive difference for the betterment of others. She is a natural leader who inspires by her completely fine character, her concern for others, and her gifted talents. That's Mr. Jones. Claire Anderson is an ideal representation of the student we wish to graduate from New Fairfield. She is intellectually curious academically gifted, and an advocate for her fellow students. She exhibits all the attributes that we hope for in a graduate, but above all else, she is kind. She cares about her fellow students, she cares about our faculty and staff, and she cares about New Fairfield, Mr. Brady. Ever since Claire entered the halls of New Fairfield High School, she has made it her mission to be an active participant of the school community, to affect change for all. She has made her mark here at New Fairfield High School through ambitious drives, several leadership roles, and as a valuable member of many clubs and several other organizations. Claire is unafraid to seek answers in a thoughtful and respectful way to evoke positive change. Her enthusiasm and energy, inside and out of the classroom, seems to know no boundaries. She is focused and determined to reach any goal she deems important to further her learning and to help others. Mrs. Bryan. Claire will be attending Smith College this fall with plans to pursue her dream career of becoming an archaeologist. Based upon Claire's experiences at New Fairfield High School, I have no doubt she will excel and accomplish great things in the future and make all of us here at New Fairfield extremely proud. Again, it is my pleasure to introduce Claire Enerson, class of 2023, co-valedictorian.
Thank you so much, and thank you to all the teachers who contributed to that speech. This is the last day I planned ahead for. It was never difficult to see what would come next. Every year I've gone to school, summer breaks wedged in between, and broken up with childhood milestones. But these were always easily predicted and carefully arranged. And then there was me. I've had a homework planner since I was 11. I've lived by due dates and held myself to my own expectations. And so I've always known what every month and year would look like. After today, my clear blue, careful plans drop off into fog. I can tell you where I'm going to college, what degree I want, what I want to do with it. But even my most meticulous designs are guesswork now that I can change my mind about any of it. As comforting as it is to know what will happen next, predictability is boring. Change your mind 100 times. We have the time for it. After spending over 10 years in school with all of you, I'm so excited to see what your lives become. Artists, nurses, pilots, parents, teachers, and scientists, whatever path you choose, career or otherwise, I hope you won't plan too far ahead. I'm still learning not to, but I think we'll be better for it. For now, I'll keep my homework planner, but otherwise, I hope that life will surprise us. I hope we'll travel and explore and love and never see any of it coming because we just didn't think to plan ahead. Before I go, I want to say thank you to everyone who got us here today. Thank you to the teachers, coaches, administrators, paraprofessionals, counselors, class advisors, and parents who have supported us during our time at New Fairfield Schools. I want to especially thank my family and my friends for their endless support, and especially for my mom for always believing in and fighting for me. Class of 2023. I'm so happy for all of us, and I wish you the brightest opportunities and best of luck. Thank you.
I would now like to invite the senior members of the Symphonic Band with their director, Mr. Hounsel, and performing Mr. Blue Sky.
Good evening, everyone. Let me try that again. Good evening, everyone. It's my honor and privilege to congratulate the class of 2023 on this special day. As superintendent, I've enjoyed getting to know this class by attending many of your events. I'm in awe of your academic accomplishments, your performance on stage, displaying your musical and theatrical talents, and your exploits on the athletic fields. But what I've enjoyed most are those small moments when I've had a chance to speak with many of you one-on-one. You've taught me a great deal about what it means to be a rebel. Asking good questions, staying true to yourself, and following your passions are descriptors that come to mind. The future is bright for you, as I'm confident that you will pursue your dreams vigorously as you leave high school. Now, we are at the moment we've all been waiting for. Mr. Cipollone, Chairman of the Board of Education, following a thorough review by New Fairfield High School administrators and counselors, I certify that members of the class of 2023 presented today, the 16th day of June 2023, have met all the requirements as delineated in the New Fairfield Board of Education policy and state law and are ready to graduate.
Ashlyn Abate. Elena Adesso. Eric Alarcon. Amelia Alexei. Ethan Alvarez. Zachary Anderson. Michelle Antman. Jacob Urijema. Siobhan Barton. Tatiana Avendano. Dominic Bardelli. Eliana Bay Wagner. Brooke Burney. Thomas Bach. Madeline Brightfield. Helen Brindice. Evelyn Butorak. Brady Carraher. Woo! Andrew Cassio. Madeline Catanese. Happy birthday, Maddie. Georgia Chadwick. Ariah Charles. Mason Cipriani. Mayvon Cohen. Michael Cohen. Francis Caleo Pinheiro. Marina Correa. Ryan Corrigan. Kirillos Forgi. Kaylin Kroot. Mia Danucci. Megan DeBellis. Simeon DeCoster. Francis DeLengo. Joseph Del Campo. Grace DeMarco. Colin DeKnight. Nina DeMarzo. Sabrina Donnelly. Sean Donovan. Foster Doucette. Benjamin Doobie. Jacob Dudas. Tyler Dunn. Tyler Ellertson. Cameron Fairchild. Tyler Fetchy. Kira Fennell. Ryan Fitzpatrick. Thomas Foley. Kaiki Fortunato. Dylan Ganji. Kyle Garbowski. Joel Geyer. Savannah Goodness. Galen Goodamond. Michael Graziano. Tanner Halpin. Bailey Hancock. Carter. Eduardo Hernandez Monroy. Cassie Heuer. Jack Hirsch. Ava Jakasek. Christopher Kakos. Mia Commonson. Aiden Kaplanis. Adriana Kina. Grace Kirsting. Kayla Killian. Madeline Kreska. JB Kruger. Kieran Kuzma. Carol Abounty. Martin Lagerman. Jessica Latassa. Thomas Leary. Christopher Ligori. Gia Ligori. Tatiana Linares. Kyle Lovett. Sarah Mador. Milan Mancini. Alexander Marshall. Sophia Martini. Justin McCormack. Colin McKenzie. Sky Melendez. Felicia Melfi. Olivia Melton. James Mears. Dylan Makita. Crossafisa Malika. Holly Mompion. Gavin Moan. Brandon Montalvo. Mackenzie Morus.
Phoebe Optal. Grayson Orlowski. Aiden Palencia. Daniel Pankiv. Caitlin Payrill. Natalie Perugini. Janine Perez. Julia Perillo. Sage Perry. Brianna Perrin. Leslie Pires. Emma Petrulli. Derek Prado. Lisa Marie Preci. Laura Reed Langford. Madeline Riley. Haley Remington. Ryan Reyes. Paige Rieger. Biagio Rina. Pearl Rogers Anderson. Taylor Rome. Megan Rizalski. Quincy Sanderson. Adrian Shushat. Helen Seda. Melanie Segura. Max Shapiro. Melanie Sorez. Alexander Sorter. Joseph Stelzel. Gabriel Tavares. Yeah. Robert Tenasaka. Yeah. Bella Tersini. Douglas Trainer. David Trellowit. Casey Turner. Caitlin Van Steen. Samantha Van Steen. Evelyn Vishko. Kevin Vishko. Nathaniel Voice. Jack Wanzik. Liam Wexler. Catherine Williams. Damian Willis. Ashley Wood. Brielle Zaney. Shannon Zondervan.
At this time, I'd like to invite the senior members of the choir to join Mr. Gadlock and the chamber singers for Wanting Memories.
Sitting here wanting memories to teach me to see the beauty in the world through my own eyes. You used to the pains of life were gone. You said you'd comfort me in times like these, and now I need you, and now I need you. And you are gone. So I am sitting here wanting memories to teach me, to see the beauty in the world through my own. Since you've gone and left me, there's been so little beauty, but I know I saw clearly through your eyes. Now the world outside is such a cold and bitter place. Here inside I have few things that will console. And when I try to hear your voice above the storms of life, then I remember that I was old. Yes, I am sitting here wanting memories to teach me to see the beauty in the world through my own eyes. Yes, I am sitting here wanting memories to teach me to see the beauty in the world through my own eyes. Think on the things that made me feel so wonderful when I was young. I think on the things that made me laugh, made me dance, made me sing. I think on the things that made me grow into a being full of pride. I think on these things, for they are true. And I am sitting here wanting memories to teach me to see the beauty in the world through my own eyes. I thought that you were gone, but now I know you're with me. You are the voice that whispers all I need to hear. I know a please, a thank you, and a smile will take me far. I know that I am you, and you are me, and we are one. I know that who I am is numbered in each grain of sand. I know that I've been blessed again and over again. Yes, I am sitting here wanting memories to teach me to see the beauty in the world through my own eyes. Yes, I am sitting here wanting memories to teach me to see the beauty in the world through my own eyes.
At this time, I'd like to invite Dylan Ganji and Evelyn Butorak to the stage.
Hello, everyone. For those who do not know me, I'm Evelyn Butorak, and this is Dylan Ganji. And growing up in New Fairfield has been incredibly memorable, something that not a lot of people can say that they have done. Our town is unique and has come with many great memories. Many of us were blessed enough to grow up together, which makes all of us so close. Our 4 years here at New Fairfield High School have been filled with memories many of us won't forget.
Ranging from Friday Night Lights, junior and senior prom, athletic senior nights, plays, concerts, and bonds that we've created. These are the times of our lives that we will always replay in our heads. As we sit here all today, we can finally say that we did it. We've graduated high school and are moving on. So to that, we say congratulations to all of you and best of luck. Shout out BB 2.0.
Oh, yeah!
Now, graduates, please stand. And on the count of three, move your tassels from the right to the left.
One, two, three.
As we bring today's ceremony to a close, I once again want to extend my thanks to the New Fairfield Public Schools custodial and maintenance staff for all of the work that goes into hosting a home field graduation ceremony. I want to especially thank for their hard work over the last couple of days our head custodian, Jim Hunt, who was preparing for two graduations simultaneously and led this effort along with Jesse Barney, Chris Soselski, and Dylan McGrath. Thank you to all of you. I'd like to thank Karen Graziano and the New Fairfield High School PTO for all the beautiful decorations and making the ceremony special. And to your class advisors, Mrs. McDermott, Mrs. Perzaglia, aided by their partner in crime, Ms. Randlett, for helping make this day and this year extra special for the class of 2023. Thank you to Mr. Chaplot for guiding you over these last 4 years. I also want to thank Ms. Priscilla Nuremberg and our secretarial staff for the hard work they put into organizing every aspect of today's events and making today memorable for all. And of course, once again, thank you to the fantastic teachers, counselors, paraprofessionals, nurses, and staff who have helped every one of these students make it to today and be prepared for what lies ahead. Graduates, cherish the friendships you've built, have lofty goals, and don't plan too far ahead so that you can be open to the surprises that come your way. Spread hope and happiness, and always, always remember that you are a rebel. Class of 2023, you have broken free. Ladies and gentlemen, please join me in welcoming the next generation of rebel alumni.